It's always sunny in Arizona, right?
It really is.
And of course, if you didn't know, May is Melanoma Awareness Month.
Right, so we want to help you recognize the signs and kind of prepare yourself and keep yourself safe here as we head into Melanoma Awareness Month and all the time here. So we brought in a specialist, Dr. Jayshree Gamath from A to Z Dermatology. Thanks for being here this morning.
It's my pleasure. I'm excited to be here too.
Oh, good. Well, you know, we have sunshine in Arizona again all year long. It's super key here, right? To be aware of skin cancer issues.
Always.
Yeah. Is melanoma a big thing here?
It's a major big thing, not even here, but overall in the whole country.
Okay.
But Arizona being the most sunniest state among all the states, yes, the risk is pretty high.
Okay, so what should people be doing?
So we should be always buying a sunscreen that should say broadband,
okay,
or UVA or UVB protection rays, because that's one of the most common way to protect our skin from skin cancer.
The broadband, you said?
Yes.
I'm not quite familiar with that. Can you educate me a little bit of what
Absolutely.
That means?
Absolutely. So many years back, we used to always make sunscreen with UVB,
yes,
radiation blockage,
yeah,
but the broadband covers UVA as well. So
wow,
we need a sunscreen that covers both of those rays.
And you brought some examples here. Do we need to look out for certain SPFs above something?
So I recommend SPF 30 or higher, because 30 or higher would block about 97% of UV radiation.
Okay.
And that's pretty ideal for most of our skin types.
And any of these would be ideal?
I mean, I would recommend anything, like I said, it says broadband on it.
Yes.
So there's some of the examples of a good broadband sunscreen.
Read the labels.
And hats are always a plus. I often have told people from out of town that if you have a sunburn in Arizona, people actually kind of stare at you at times, you know, because here in Arizona, we do take this pretty seriously, and a hat is always critical.
Agree. And you should always buy a hat. You should also say a sun protective factor in it. So it has UV factor built
in it.
It
does.
It's even
really
better.
Interesting. Yes.
Okay. It just blocks the UV radiation through your clothing.
Let me ask you this, you know, because I think we're extra sensitive. I have a little spot because I run outside and I get worried. What should we be looking for, and how do we know we maybe need to see a doctor?
And that's great, because most of the time we don't know what we're looking at.
Right.
I always say we need to look at a spot and evaluating by what we call A, B, C, D, and E.
Okay.
So A stands for asymmetry, B stands for borders, C stands for color, D stands for diameter, and E stands for evolving, meaning changing mold.
Okay.
So when you look at a mold, the mold should look perfectly round. So mm-hmm. imagine you were cutting this mold with an imaginary line. It should have a both side looking equal.
Okay.
And it should have one color. So not too many pigment mixing in there. And it should not be bigger than a pencil eraser head,
okay,
or bigger than a pinky tip of a pinky finger.
All right.
And you should not have any pain.
Okay, well, good to know.
Good.
And if you have any questions, you can always call Dr. Gamath as well. We'll have your information on our website. Thank you so much. Great information, and keep that in mind.
No kidding. Lather on the sunscreen.
Exactly.
ABC 15 Mornings continues right after this. Doctor, thank you so much.
It's all pleasure to be